to learn about a new type of essays in English, which is very important, and especially when we deal with scientific topics such as global warming. So what are expository essays? This is what you are going to learn about in this lesson. So I'll try to speak slowly because this will be very important for you. So in the final exam, you may be asked to write a narrative essay or an expository essay. So what is an expository essay? It's a genre or a type or kind of writing which tends to explain. Then first of all, let me give you some verbs that simplify things for you. Explain. Here, when you write, you need to explain. I am not asking you to write a story, a daily activity, a movie that you watch it. Here, we are trying to give a logical explanation. So, first of all, you will try to explain or to illustrate or to clarify. They are all have similar meanings. What will you clarify? Something in a way that it becomes clear for readers. So the readers don't know a lot, for example, about global warming. So in this case, you tell them about the definition of global warming, for example, the most important reasons that lead to global warming and the effects or some solutions. You can suggest some solutions for them. So here in the expository essay, we need to explain, to illustrate, or to clarify to the reader a certain topic. So it will be based on facts. So here I am not talking about something you have watched, for example, or a trip you have been. I am talking about facts. I am talking about logical explanation. So in this case, I don't expect the writer, for example, to express his emotions. I don't expect the writer to express his emotions. So we don't write about our emotions in such genre of writing. In the narrative essay, you can say, I am sad, I am happy, I am excited, I am enthusiastic, or whatever here. Avoid this. Here we are talking about facts, and especially we can talk about reasons and effects, and this is one of the types under the heading of expository essay that you will learn about today. So like other essays, let's now talk about the structure of this essay. So like other essays, it consists of introduction. So introductory paragraph or introduction. And I taught you in details about the first paragraph or in the introductory paragraph in earlier lesson. And I told you it consists of topic sentence, background information, and thesis statement. And in this case, the thesis statement will be very important. As we read in the last article about global warming, the writer told us in the beginning that there are several environmental problems. But in the end of his introduction, he told us that in this article, he will discuss global warming. So thesis statement, the last sentence in the introduction will be very important in order to tell the writer about your direction or about your purpose or about the central idea that you will discuss. Now, the main body paragraphs, especially when I talk about cause and effect essay, we can talk or write about the basic reasons or causes, or we can write about the effects of these reasons. So, body paragraphs that prove the statement and a conclusion. You know, in a conclusion paragraph, we summarize all essential points. We only summarize or we mirror what we have written about in the introduction, or we give, for example, solutions. So it is relating to the situation. Now, the chief purpose of expository essay is to give a logical explanation, not emotions. Not emotions. To give logical explanation, not emotions. Here we are not talking about emotions. Rather, we are talking about facts. About facts. Now, what are the main types of expository writing? I chose to you six important types of expository writing essays, and today we'll learn about the first one. So there are many different types of expository essays you can write. The most common types of expository essays students are required to write are, so in the case of you, and we are talking about the exams that you will do in the final exam, you will be asked, for example, to write a cause and effect essay. So this is very important essay for you, or a problem solution essay, or a comparison and contrast essay. So today it is shaded in yellow for you. You will learn how to write the cause and effect essay. So earlier, dear students, you learned how to write a narrative essay or a story, a short story. Today you are going to learn how to write a scientific essay, and definitely the cause and effect essay. Now, another important type under the expository writing, the problem and solution, in which you give a problem and you find a solution. Or when we make a comparison and contrast, when we talk about comparison, when we write about comparison, we mean similarities between things, and the contrast means differences. Also, we have another type, the process essay or how-to. We can write about definition, the classification, but the first three types are the most important ones for you that I'll try my best to teach you. Today, you will learn the problem, and today you will learn the cause and effect essay. So today you will learn the cause and effect essay. So number one, the cause and effect essay. The cause and effect essay. So it is very clear that it is about reasons and results. So cause and effects, the same as reasons and results. So we can say it is a reasons and results essay. And here we ask ourselves two questions. Why did it happen? So for example, think that we are writing about global warming that we discussed in an earlier article. So why did it happen? So why did global warming happen, and what are the outcomes? What are the effects? What are the results of global warming? So you need to answer these two questions. Why? So here we are talking about the reasons or the causes, and why? What are the outcomes? And here we write about the effects or consequences or results of this topic that we are writing about. So such essays are used for scientific topics. As I told you, in order to write about scientific topics, we need to write an expository essay, because it explores or identifies the nature of things and their probable effects on us. Here we can include environmental problems, for example, global warming, water pollution, air pollution, etc. And we write about the impact or the effect of these topics or these phenomena on our life. But pay attention, very important note, dear students. Here, I want to tell you something important when you write your expository essay. In some cases, and that really happened with me, I asked the student to write only the causes, of a global warming, but because they saw that in each time they should write about causes and effects, they write about the effects, so I didn't ask them to do that. So, very important to understand this note. So, it's also possible for short exam essays, and here I am talking about exams. Only the causes are mentioned. Only the causes are written about, not both, or only the results. So, for example, let me give you an example to understand what I am talking about. Discuss or explain. So, discuss or explain. Discuss the causes and effects, and here they are in red for you. Discuss the causes and effects. Discuss the causes and effects of a global warming. So we need to write about causes and effects. Now explain the causes of global warming. Here we need only to write about the causes. Now discuss the effects. We need to write about only the effects. So you don't need to write about the causes at all. So pay attention. Causes and effects. Causes only or effects only. Okay. Now what about the structure? Now, okay, you want to write your cause and effect essay, but how to organize this essay? So what about the structure of this essay? Here we have two important ways to write about this type of essay. First of all, we have the block structure and we have the chain structure. And after I explain, I'll show you the chart in front of you or the illustration in order to help. Sorry, in order to help you. So we have two main ways to structure a cause and effect essay. The first one is the block structure. The block structure. The second one is the chain structure. So what is the difference between the two structures? Here, when I use the block structure, I write all the causes in one paragraph. I list all the causes in one paragraph and all the effects in another paragraph. So the paragraph will be, one paragraph will be dedicated for all the causes or the reasons, while the other paragraph will be dedicated for all the effects. Well, for the effects. So another type is the chain. Here the case is different. Here each cause will be followed immediately or so or immediately by an effect. So we write the cause and it is followed by an effect. Now this effect will make another cause. Okay, and so on. So in order to make it easy for you, I'll show you this chart or this diagram. So, or this illustration. So, block, okay, block and chain. Here we are talking about the block and the chain ways to write an expository essay and definitely cause and effect essay. Here, we start with an introduction. We start with an introduction. Dear students, pay attention. Here in this illustration, we are going to read about the block and the chain ways that you use in order to write your expository essay. So here we, as I told you, we write all the causes in one paragraph and then we write all the effects after a transition sentence or paragraph. So all the introduction, all the causes, and then in another paragraph, all the effects, and this is called the block. The block way to write your cause and effect essay. Now, chain. Chain here, also we have an introduction, but here we have one cause, and this cause lead to an effect. So the effect will be the cause of another effect, and so on. So here we write all the causes and all the effects in one paragraph. So this is the difference. This is called the block way and this is called the chain way. Now what about signal words that are used in this type of essays? So in order to write our expository essay or in order to write our cause and effect essay, we need to memorize, to learn by heart some expressions, some transition words, some linking words that may help us while we are writing our essay. And here C is used to indicate a cause, as you can see. So here you can write a cause instead of this C. And here A is used to indicate an effect. So instead of E, you can write about an effect. So the first cause of here, I am giving you signal words in order to make you write your essay easily. So the first cause, cause of what? Of an effect. So in this bracket, you need to write about, you don't use brackets, of course, while you are writing, but here it's only a symbol for you to understand. So the first cause of what? For example, of a global warming. So global warming is a result or an effect. So the first cause of global warming is, for example, carbon dioxide. Another, the next reason is methane and so on. Now, because of, here we need a cause, because of carbon dioxide, for example, global warming has become a serious problem. As a result of, for example, carbon dioxide, global warming has increased. As a consequence, etc. Here, we can start with E. Here, we can start with an effect. And here, we start with the effect. So, E, for example, global warming, is it due to global warming? Here, you write global warming, for example. Global warming is due to, is because of, is the effect of, are all the same, because of carbon dioxide or greenhouse gases. So global warming is the consequence of carbon dioxide. And here are examples for you. So worsening pollution levels in cities are due to. So here, this is the reason. It is in a pink color and underlined for you. So the increased use of cars, here is the reason. The increased use of cars, and it is not necessary to write about the causes in the first part of the sentence, as you can see. So we can start with the result. So worsening pollution levels in cities are due to, and this is the cause. Why do we have pollution in our cities? Because of or due to the increased use of cars. So here, we mentioned the reason and then the result. So because of what? Because of a reason. What is this reason? It is the increased use of cars, and here the effect pollution levels in cities are worsening. Worsening means becoming worse. Now, as a result of, and here we write the cause, as a result of the increased use of cars, pollution levels in cities are worsening. Now, the effects of, and here we are not writing about the causes, the effects of what? Of that cause, which is the increased use of cars is a worsening of pollution levels in cities. Now, signal words or important words when we want to write the effects. So here, the first effect of, and here we write the cause here. So, for example, the first effect of water pollution, the first effect of water pollution is, for example, diseases, fatal diseases. So the first effect of water pollution is the first cause. Sorry, I repeat again for you. The first effect, here we are writing about the causes. Don't forget, C represent or indicate the causes. So the first effect of a cause, here we need to mention a cause. For example, when we write about causes of water pollution, we can say, for example, untreated sewage, for example. We can write about industrial waste. So the first effect of industrial waste, the first effect of untreated sewage or oil from tankers, for example, is water pollution. So we write about the effects here in this space are water pollution. Another result of, for example, chemical waste is fatal diseases and so on. So as a result, here we are writing about results. We can write about water pollution or land pollution, as consequences are the same. So here we need to write about the cause. So the cause, which is, for example, chemical waste, for example, results in water pollution and so on. So chemical waste, for example, causes water pollution. Here, another example, oil from tankers has an effect on our environment or water pollution, etc. Here are examples for you.
Yes, dear students, let's now read some examples about effects. Cars are used increasingly for transport as a consequence, as a result. Here, we started with the cause and now we'll read the effect. Pollution levels in cities are worsening. So cars are used increasingly for transport as a result. So this word is used when we want to talk about or write about results. Pollution levels in cities are worsening. Now another example, increased use of cars for transport affect pollution levels in cities. So pollution levels in cities, and it is underlined for you, is the effect. And now the last example, increased use of cars for transport is one of the causes. So the first part of this sentence is about the cause. It's the cause which will lead to the effect, and that will be worsening pollution levels in cities. So increased use of cars for transport, this is the cause. So this is one of the causes. This is one of the causes of worsening pollution levels in cities, or it leads to an effect. And what is this effect? It is worsening pollution levels in cities. This is everything for today.